Hello friends, hope you all are doing well and staying safe. Welcome to yet another video of the Football Mania, the one-stop platform where you can get all the latest news, updates and highlights about my opinions about the football happenings across the globe. So in today's video, I'll be talking about one thing which helps fans to become more curious about their beloved clubs just before a season is about to start. Yes, my friends, I'm talking about the summer transfer window, which has been a really exciting window for many reasons. Not just because of the fact that we had the ongoing Euros or the Copa America, but for the fact that a lot of these players who were playing in the Euros were actually targeted by these clubs, right? And we can see some big, big deals happening, and all the major clubs, including PSG or Manchester United or Real Madrid, have done some good business, I should say. And this brings me to my top 5 transfers for this window, and I hope you all would mostly agree with me. So without further ado, here we go. If you ever looking for a fullback in your team who can bomb on the right hand side without any real inhibition and whipping those vicious crosses, it has to be none other than a 22-year-old who has caught everyone's eye in world football. Yes, I'm talking about Achraf Hakimi, one of the star players for Inter Milan last season, which helped them to win the Italian Serie A, and now has completed his move to PSG. This was always on the cards with most of the big clubs on the radar, on the lookout for him. And yes, he has been very versatile as a player, and I have only laurels for him. I only have praise for him as a player. He has been outstanding. Last season he scored 7 goals in the entire season, including all the competitions, and had 11 assists. And for a right back, if you are saying, if you are just imagining yourself to be a right back and talking about these numbers, you will be taking it all day long, I'm sure about that. And if Achraf Hakimi can provide the same type of quality in this PSG squad, I'm sure PSG will be challenging for not only the Ligue 1, but also the Champions League, the Coupe de France, which has been haunting them for many seasons now. And possibly they might go for a quadruple, who knows. Credit to PSG. Nasser El Khelaifi, their Qatari business owner, has been, driving the club forward in the right direction. We have seen how Mauricio Pochettino has been building a good squad. And I just hope PSG, after so many successive runs, good runs in the Champions League, they can finally win it this time around. And I hope that with the star-studded players like Neymar, Mbappe, and even Sergio Ramos now coming at the back, it will be a really exciting time for PSG going into the new season. So let's wait and watch what Hakimi can offer, and I hope he really does well. David Alaba from Bayern Munich to Real Madrid. Wow, this is yet another huge summer signing which we all were actually expecting, to be honest. And the way David Alaba has transformed himself as a player is just incredible. In his 13 years at Bayern Munich, he won 10 Bundesliga titles, 6 German Cups and 2 Champions Leagues. Wow, that is not a bad CV to have, right? So when you have a caliber player like David Alaba coming to your club in Real Madrid, you have to take him with open hands. And well, he has signed a 5-year contract with the Los Blancos, and I'm expecting him to really solidify their defense. And this was one thing which was actually creating a lot of issues for Real Madrid last season. And the talisman in the shape of Sergio Ramos now leaving the club, it was really important to understand who will be taking up the void, filling up that gap. And yes, I think David Alaba is a very, very strong player who is good on the ball and can really command the backline. He has good leadership qualities as well. So I'll be really surprised if Real Madrid concede a lot of goals in the coming season. So I'm as a neutral, I'm really happy for Real Madrid, even though I'm a big fan of Barcelona. But let's hope that Alaba can do what he does best, and that is defend. So yes, it is going to be an exciting watch, and I'm hoping to see him in action soon. Another talented midfielder who has caught the eye of many big clubs in this transfer window is Rodrigo De Paul from Argentina. Well, we all saw him in the Copa America, and the way he played was just exceptional. His command in midfield, his physical abilities as a player, and his versatile game is there for everyone to see. His vision, his tackling, and all the attributes which you expect from a midfielder are there in him. And with his crucial assist, we saw Argentina clinching the Copa America. And even before the tournament, if we just look at his stats for Udinese in the Serie A, he has a record 184 appearances in which he has scored 34 goals and 36 assists. For a 3 year spell in a club, that's not bad, right? For a unknown midfielder, really. I never knew about him until I saw him in Copa America, and that's what such big competitions do to you. You look at a tournament and try to spot good players, and you find a gem. And to be honest, he's just 27. He's in the prime of his game, and he's going into a team like Atletico Madrid, who has signed him on a 5 year deal for a record 35 million euros. Well, that's, to be honest, a steal for Atletico Madrid, because the quality that he possesses brings much more to the table. And having a manager like Diego Simeone, a person from Argentina who can understand your playing style, is something which will have a great sync going forward. So I'm really expecting he does really well for Atletico, and I'll be really, really happy for him if he can produce the same quality which he did for Argentina. So let's hope that he does well. I'm always excited when I hear unheard talent coming to a big league like the Premier League. And in this transfer window, we have seen yet another unheard talent in the form of 22-year-old Zambian striker Patson Daka, who has been just amazing for Salzburg in the Austrian Bundesliga. He scored a record 27 goals in 28 appearances for the Salzburg team last season, which helped them to clinch their eighth straight Austrian Bundesliga. This comes on the back of a successful stint which he had in other clubs in Europe, and the transfer value, if you see, is just 23.5 million. For me, it's a real steal again, because Leicester City is one such team which has been consistent for the last couple of seasons, and under Brendan Rodgers, they have a very solid unit. And they have laid the foundation really well with winning the FA Cup last season. And the striking role in that team will not be the sole responsibility of Jamie Vardy. We will see Patson Daka in this team. Also with Iheanacho, they have a really good attacking front three, I would say. And if they can integrate Patson Daka in this mix, it will be really good. And I have not heard much of him, but yes, looking at those numbers, I'll be really happy to see him do well. And we all know the Premier League is a very tough league. It's a highly physical league, but it will be interesting to see how he copes up with the new challenge. Coming to my top transfer in this summer transfer window, yes, it has to be Jadon Sancho, who has made his finally much awaited move from Borussia Dortmund to Manchester United for a record 85 million euros. Yes, that's right. And I don't know, this has been an ongoing saga right from the end of last season, and even Manchester United were really expecting the young winger to join them. They were really desperate that he comes back to England, and yes, they have finally made the move. Over recent seasons, he has been just exceptional for Borussia Dortmund, wherein he has played a record 137 matches and has scored 50 goals. And his link up with Erling Haaland was there for everyone to see. It was a real joy to watch. And when you see such young players, you always realize that they have those trickeries, those skills, and they're really expressive as a player. And Manchester United were having the likes of Dan James in their wings, but he was someone who was not really expressive or was not getting enough minutes, I would say, under Ole Gunnar Solskjaer. But with the likes of Jadon Sancho coming in from the right, and again Marcus Rashford from the left, and you have Edinson Cavani, who is spearheading the attack. I really feel that this Manchester United team has just strengthened, and Jadon Sancho is the perfect type of player who you can have in your team, who can produce those vicious crosses, who can take on defenders and leave them for dead. So I really hope, even though I'm not a big United fan, I really hope Jadon Sancho does really well. And with this, we come to the end of this window. If you like my list of top five transfers, you can hit the like button. And in the comment section, you can also suggest your picks from this summer transfer window. So until next time, stay safe and take care.